price of vegetables from Malaysia has skyrocketed over the past few months as the monsoon season wreaks havoc on crops across the causeway. Some produce prices have hit a decade-high record. Lily Ying and Heidi Ng with more.
Singapore has never seen a downpour like this in three decades for the month of January. And across the causeway, vegetable crops are getting rained out too.
Lately, because of the continuous day and night rain, heavy rain, and there are a lot of landslides, and there are a lot of flooding, and no sunlight at all, all the production has dropped a lot. Yeah.
That's caused some vegetables to hit eye-watering prices.
Chinese celery prices has gone up about 400%. Then the tomato price from last week to this week, it has gone up 150%. Originally, there are only a handful of growers growing this type of Chinese celery. And with the bad weather, then the price has gone up a lot. In terms of tomatoes, it's a fruit, it needs sunlight to be ripened.
One wet market vendor who's been in the business for over 30 years says he's never seen a situation like this before. He has to put in more effort to secure more stock, but the prices are discouraging buyers. And with Malaysia announcing a two-week limited lockdown, importers are waiting to see if that would further affect vegetable supply and prices. They don't expect any issues for now.
Right now, we don't have any information saying that it will affect our logistic companies that delivery of essential products like our vegetables. Past experience, there is no disruption. So I think this time it will be the same.
To ensure food security, Singapore imports food from more than 170 countries and jurisdictions.